The plans that heaven has for you will all too soon unfold. So many different prayers I pray for all that you might do. But most of all, I want to know you're walking in the truth. And if I never told you, I want you to know that as I watch you grow, I pray that God would fill your heart with dreams, and that faith gives you your life so sweet. Oh,
Please stand for the national anthem.
Give honor to the American flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Let's give honor to the Christian flag. I pledge allegiance to the Christian flag and to the Savior for whose kingdom it stands. One Savior, crucified, risen, and coming again with life and liberty to all who believe.
Let's give honor to the Bible. I pledge allegiance to the Bible, God's holy word. I will make it a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. I will hide God's words in my heart that I may not sin against God.
Jeremiah 29:11. Before I know the thoughts that I think toward you, says the Lord, thoughts of peace and not evil, to give you a future and a hope.
Bow your heads and close your eyes. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for this day. Lord, please help us have a good graduation today, Lord. Lord, please put your healing hand on the people who are sick and the people who are in the hospital and the people who have a disability. Lord, we love you and we thank you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Please remain standing for the DCS Almanac. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Please be seated. And welcome to the fifth grade crossover ceremony. I'd like to share a very well-known scripture with you. It's found in Proverbs 22:6. It says, "Train up a child in the way he should go, and when he is old, he will not depart from it." Our mission as a church and as schools is to glorify God by making disciples for Christ. And our mission can be stated in many forms, and this is yet another way to restate that we strive to make disciples out of everyone, including and especially children. We try to instill in them a worldview where they are trained in the way that they should go, the way of the Lord, so that when they are much older, they will stay on those paths which lead to Christ. You know, we have now every year at Dade Christian School 4 graduation ceremonies. There's kindergarten, there's the fifth grade crossover, there's the ESC ceremony, and of course there's the 12th grade graduation. And of the 4, typically, this is the least attended. I don't know if it's the least important. In my heart, it's just as important as every other graduation. For this reason, these children are crossing over not only to sixth grade, but really from childhood into adolescence. They cross over from being considered children to being considered young adults. And now, at this age, the age that they are about to enter into, that's when we lose a lot of them from following the paths of the Lord. It is this age right now where their worldview is going to be molded and forged for the rest of their lives. And it's at this age that many of them follow other paths other than the way that we want to train them up so that they do not depart when they are old, the ways of the Lord. So let me encourage you. Let's continue to partner up. Christian education is a triangle. God is at the top, at the apex. Parents and the school are at the base. And as we seek together the Lord, we come more and more together to bring Christian education and a Christian worldview to the children that are behind me. And we can together fulfill these words, "Train up a child in the way he should go, and when he is old, he will not depart from it." We want these children behind me to continue for the rest of their lives to serve the Lord with all of their hearts. God bless you. I turn things over to Miss Martinez.
Good morning, everyone. At this time, we are going to begin with some awards. We are going to start with our subject area awards. 2 students from each class have received these awards, so they've received either a superior ranking or they're the top students in that subject area. From Ms. Suffrage's class receiving the math award, we have Mr. Richie Prophet. Also receiving the math award is Ms. Haley Rivman. Receiving the math award from Ms. Ubia's class, we have Mr. Zay Fawn Rose.
Fix your hair.
Also receiving the math award, we have Mr. Lucas Lopez. From Mrs. Martinez's class receiving the math award, Miss Juliet Martinez. And Miss Sophia Martinez. Moving on to language arts. Receiving the language arts award from Miss Suffrage's class, we have Miss Haley Rivman. Also receiving the Language Arts Award is Mr. Ethan Jameson. From Ms. Ubia's class, we have Mr. Terry Wallace. And Mr. Lucas Lopez. Receiving Language Arts Award from Mrs. Martinez's class, Miss Alexa Gravely. And Miss Mia Lynn Peen. Moving on to the Bible Awards. From Miss Suffrage's class, we have Mr. Ethan Jameson. Also receiving the Bible Award from Miss Suffrage's class, Mr. Richie Prophet. From Ms. Ubia's class, we have Mr. Terry Wallace. Also from Ms. Ubia's class, we have Ms. Claire Majors. From Mrs. Martinez's class receiving the Bible Award, we have Miss Nicole Hernandez. And Mr. Tiago Gaviria Ortiz. Receiving the Science Award from Ms. Suffrage's class, we have Ms. Esther Bertrand. And Mr. Tony Buckles. Receiving the Science Award from Ms. Ubia's class, we have Zay Fon Rose. We also have Mr. Rome Noland. From Mrs. Martinez's class, receiving the Science Award, Mr. Alexis Gutierrez. And Ms. Leilani Santana. Now for our Social Studies Awards, from Ms. Suffrage's class, we have Ms. Haley Rivman. We also have Mr. Tony Buckles. Receiving the Social Studies Award from Ms. Ubia's class, Mr. Lucas Lopez. And Mr. Braylon McMullen. From Mrs. Martinez's class receiving the Social Studies Award, we have Ms. Sophia Martinez. And Mr. Tiago Gaviria Ortiz. Moving on to the Spelling Award, from Ms. Suffrage's class, Mr. Abraham Gomez. Also receiving the Spelling Award, Ms. Anna Beatrice Diaz. The Spelling Award from Ms. Ubia's class goes to Mr. Lucas Lopez. And Ms. Raquel Araujo. From Mrs. Martinez's class receiving the Spelling Award, Ms. Nicole Hernandez. And Ms. Alexa Gravely. Receiving our music awards, we have two band students and two choir students. From band, we have Ms. Haley Rivman. We also have Mr. Richie Prophet. Receiving the choir awards, we have Ms. Juliet Martinez. We also have Mr. Terry Wallace. now for our Spanish awards. From Ms. Suffrage's class, we have Mr. Kenny Paris. Also receiving the Spanish award, Mr. Abraham Gomez. Receiving the Spanish award from Ms. Ubia's class, Ms. Ajane Ephraim. And Mr. Lucas Lopez. From Mrs. Martinez's class, receiving the Spanish award, Ms. Sophia Martinez. And Ms. Juliet Martinez. Now for our art awards from Ms. Suffrage's class, Ms. Esther Bertrand. Also receiving the art award, Ms. Anna Beatrice Diaz. Receiving the art award from Ms. Ubia's class, Raquel Araujo. And Mr. Rome Noland. From Mrs. Martinez's class, receiving the art award, Ms. Juliet Martinez. And Mr. Tiago Gavidia Ortiz. Now for computers, selected by Mrs. Chang, their computer teacher. From Ms. Suffrage's class, we have Mr. Ethan Jameson. And Ms. Anna Beatrice Diaz. From Ms. Ubia's class, receiving the computer awards, we have Mr. Terry Wallace. We also have Mr. Lucas Lopez. Receiving the computers awards from Mrs. Martinez's class, we have Ms. Sophia Martinez. And Ms. Mia Lynn Peen. And our last category for subject areas, we have the Physical Education Awards. The PE Awards from Ms. Suffrage's class goes to Richie Prophet. And Mr. Tony Buckles. The Physical Education Awards from Ms. Ubia's class goes to Jaquan Johnson. And Mr. Braylon McMullen. From Mrs. Martinez's class receiving the PE award, we have Mr. Alexis Gutierrez. And Ms. Juliet Martinez. Now we will move on to our Accelerated Reader Awards. We are going to begin with those students receiving the bronze medal for Accelerated Reader. They have read between 250,000 words to 500,000 words this school year. Receiving the bronze medal for Accelerated Reader, we have Ms. Leilani Santana. We also have Ms. Ana Beatrice Diaz. Mr. Tiago Gavidia Ortiz. Mr. Richie Prophet. And Mr. Ethan Jameson. Now for our silver medal winners for the Accelerated Reader Award. These students have read more than 500,000 words this school year. We have Ms. Sophia Martinez. Ms. Nicole Hernandez. Ms. Alexa Gravely. Ms. Haley Rivman. Ms. Mia Lynn Peen. And Ms. Juliet Martinez. Now we will present our cumulative honor roll awards for this school year. We will begin with A honor roll. The following students are being recognized for academic achievement and maintaining a cumulative 3.5 to 3.99 GPA, mainly A's, no C's, for the entire school year. Receiving the A honor roll certificate, we have Mr. Tiago Gavidia Ortiz. We also have Ms. Alexa Gravely. Also receiving the A Honor Roll for the school year, Ms. Nicole Hernandez. Also have Mr. Lucas Lopez. Receiving A Honor Roll for the school year, Ms. Haley Rivman. We also have Mr. Alexis Gutierrez. And Ms. Mia Lynn Peen. The next award is the Principal's Honor Roll Award. The following students are being recognized for academic achievement and maintaining a cumulative GPA of 4.0, which means they've kept straight A's the entire 2022 to 2023 school year. We have two recipients. First one is Ms. Juliet Martinez. Also receiving straight A's for this school year, Ms. Sophia Martinez. At this time, our fifth grade students will present us with a song.
Me.
Thank you, fifth grade. You may be seated. We will now be presenting two specialty awards. We are going to begin with the Most Improved Award. This is awarded to two students, 2 to 4, from each class who have shown great work ethic and have dramatically improved academically or behaviorally throughout the school year. These students never give up. They've pushed themselves to reach their utmost potential. Their teachers are beyond proud of all the progress they have made this school year. First up, receiving the Most Improved Award from Ms. Suffrage's class, we have Mr. Kenny Paris. Great job, Kenny. Also from Ms. Suffrage's class, we have Mr. Ethan Jameson. From Ms. Ubia's class, receiving the Most Improved Award, we have Mr. Eli Fonrose. Also receiving the Most Improved Award from Ms. Ubia and Ms. Maggie's class is Ms. Genevieve Valdez. Also receiving the Most Improved Award from Ms. Ubia and Ms. Maggie's class, we have Mr. Jaquan Johnson. Lastly, receiving this award from this class is Ms. Claire Majors. Now for the Most Improved Award from Mrs. Martinez's class. We have Ms. Mia Lynn Peen. Also receiving the Most Improved Award from Mrs. Martinez's class, we have Damani Gibson. Our next award is the Who's Who at DCS Award. This is awarded to two students from each class who have best displayed a strong Christian testimony and student leadership skills. They are a well-rounded individual who exemplifies the spirit and ideals of DCS. This student maintains high marks academically and behaviorally. They go above and beyond to represent what it truly means to be a DCS champion. First up, receiving the Who's Who Award from Ms. Suffrage's class, we have Mr. Richie Prophet. Also receiving the Who's Who at DCS Award from Ms. Suffrage's class, we have Ms. Haley Rivman. Receiving the Who's Who at DCS Award from Ms. Ubia's class, we have Mr. Terry Wallace. Also receiving the Who's Who at DCS Award from Ms. Ubia's class, Ms. Ajane Ephraim. Now for Mrs. Martinez's class, the first student receiving the Who's Who at DCS Award is Ms. Nicole Hernandez. Next, from Mrs. Martinez's class, receiving the Who's Who Award, Ms. Juliet Martinez. Let's give our award recipients one more round of applause. Now, the moment you've all been waiting for, we are going to hand out our crossover certificates to our fifth grade students who are becoming middle school students. Let's begin. First up, we have Mr. Tiago Gavidia Ortiz. They will also be receiving Bibles so they could take with them on their middle school journey. Ms. Damani Gibson. Miss Alexa Gravely. Alexis Gutierrez. Miss Nicole Hernandez. Miss Juliet Martinez. My first row may sit, my second row, stand up. Ms. Sophia Martinez. Ms. Mia Lynn Payne. Ms. Leilani Santana. Ms. Raquel Araujo. Ms. Ajane Ephraim. Mr. Elifon Rose. Mr. Zayfon Rose. Mr. Jaquan Johnson. Mr. Lucas Lopez. Miss Claire Majors. Mr. Braylon McMullen. Mr. Rome Noland. Miss Genevieve Valdez. Mr. Terry Wallace. And Ms. Esther Bertrand. Mr. Tony Buckles. Ms. Anna Beatrice Diaz. Mr. Abraham Gomez. Mr. Ethan Jameson. Mr. Kenny Paris. Mr. Richie Prophet. Ms. Haley Rivman.
Testing. Ladies and gentlemen, parents, teachers, faculty, Ms. Martinez, it's my high honor to present to you the fifth grade 2023 crossover class, now the sixth grade class. Thank you.
The world that he gave us, his one and only Son.
Well, I'm about to pray and end our ceremony, but before we do that, we do want to recognize some very special people in the lives of the graduates behind me. Without these individuals, this year would have been very, very different, and we thank God for the teachers of the now sixth graders. It's a very unique trio of women that love the Lord, very smart, are very sacrificial, and they certainly have loved on your children this year. We want to recognize Ms. Terry Martinez. Please stand, Terry, please stand. Ms. Suffrage. And Ms. Ubilla. Thank you, thank you. May God bless you. And before the prayer, I want to say that we are all, after the prayer, there's going to be a recessional. The students will leave, and then you're all invited to join them in the chapel, which is the room immediately to my left, to your right, as you exit our sanctuary, where you're going to be able to enjoy some brunch items. And let's give a hand to the crossover students. One more big hand. Let's pray. Let's all stand as we pray, please. Heavenly Father, we first want to recognize you and ascribe to you all honor, glory, and praise, because without you, nothing is possible. Father, we want to thank you for this year. At times, it has been challenging, but overall, it's been a year anointed and blessed by your hand over these now sixth graders. And we want to thank you once more for their teachers, and ask that you bless them greatly. We pray for their homes, Heavenly Father, that each home here represented by these students would be greatly blessed, that everyone who comes in and out of their house would feel your presence and your blessing over their lives. And Father, we commend these students into your hand, into your future. They've always been yours. You've always loved them. They've always belonged to you. You've only allowed us to watch over their education for a little bit. But, Father, you've always been in charge of their lives. So, as you have done so in the past, we pray that you continue to do so in their future, that wherever they go, you go before them in your spirit, and you prepare the grounds where they walk upon, so that they are blessed with every single step that they take, that their hands may prosper in everything that they endeavor to do. May they do it for you and for your glory, and may they find success according to your standards. We pray protection over their minds, over their hearts, as they move forward into adolescence, that they would always keep their thoughts upon you and their hearts open to Christ Jesus and His Word. And Father, we pray protection physically over them, over so many people that would wish harm upon them. May it never be so, Father. Watch over them, protect them, keep them from all harm, spiritual and physical. And we pray all of this in Jesus' name. Amen.